Gather round, everyone, and hear again the tale of Drakfu. Welcome back, everybody, and happy Friday. We're finally there. It's the end of the week, and where are you? You're watching Tale of Drakfu, right? Yeah, you are. And thank you for doing that. Really quick, I'm just gonna grab all of these excess auctions, because I'm just flowing with money. There we go. And we are continuing our questing in Terokkar Forest. I'm trying to think of the next place that we can go. Probably to... We've got a couple of places that are going to start stuff up. So let's just take them on one at a time. We're going to fly over to Turum. To figure out what's been going on with all those boxes that created the problem at Cenarion Thicket. Oh no! What on earth happened? And of course, once again, happy Friday to everybody. Almost there. You're almost to the weekend when you can hopefully go play WoW yourself or play that one game that you absolutely love. It just so happens that I know where the box is. Well, hi there, Mr. Lost One. And oh, look at that. There's a blood elf guarding the box. Well... That puts a whole new spin on things now, doesn't it? Sealed box. Well, now we don't have to worry about that one. And we can move on to the next one. Oh, where is it? There it is. So I think from here, we'll just go ahead and move over to take care of Ironjaw. Now this one I'm just going to point out, I might magic cut this, because Ironjaw has at least in my experience, has a really weird respawn rate. Especially if once he's been killed, you could be waiting for a while, and he respawns just in an area, not necessarily a specific point. So I've always caught him respawning in different points in that area. So I'm hoping that he's there, but if he isn't, then I'm just going to go ahead and magic cut it while I figure that out. Fell weed is still yellow, so we'll grab that too. There we go. So we just have to find the area. Thankfully, it's not too far off. But hopefully everybody is having a good Friday. Hopefully nobody had any TPS reports to file or anything like that. Heh heh. F you, Mr. Warpstalker. I saw what you were going to do. And I wasn't cool with it. I'm just saying. Okay. So we should be almost to the area that Ironjaw usually is around. It's one of those things where I'm just not sure, because I know he has also been reworked and patched, so they may have changed him. But this has been my experience with this stupid Ironjaw quest. Oh, actually, you know what? I'm going to take this guy down too, because he actually has an item. Stone Gazer! Come here.
Come here, I'm Drakfu, I punch you! I punch you hard!
Oh, never mind, he doesn't have an item. There is a quest involving him, though. I'm just not sure who gives it. You have to go over and kill Stonegazer completion for a quest. Yep, I'm going to go ahead and magic cut it while I look for Ironjaw, so be right back. There he is. Okay, we're back. Here is Ironjaw. It looks like he was set to respawn, so let's take him down. There we go. We now have Ironjaw's pelt. And let's move on to the next one, which is actually going to be killing a bunch of peons. But you'll notice that there is a Blood Elf camp here. Gee, I wonder if we'll actually quest there at some point. Now, there was some Terracone over there. I'm not going to risk getting it. Okay, I'm going to do a quick flying break while we make our way to the... never mind, actually, because I can see it off in the distance. But that doesn't mean I'm going to stop collecting things. Because after all, this is how I get money. Yeah, if you could see that broken Horde outpost... That is where we are going to deal with more Fellorks. Yeah, you thought you were done with them in Hellfire? No, they're all over the place. We'll deal with fellow orcs, I think, in pretty much every zone in Outland. And there they are. So these are the warped peons that we need to take care of. And all we have to do is kill another 10 of them, and then we're okay. But it has to be warped peons, which makes things kind of difficult. So I'm going to go ahead and speed things up. Be right back. Okay, that is all 12. So now that we've taken care of that, let's go ahead and do a quick flying... Unwelcome Presence is actually nearby. That's right, because we need to go to a little horde encampment right here. So you can see the little horde tents right there. And it's the Stonebreaker Camp. And this is where you turn it in. So, Shadowstalker Cade. Cade hisses at you. Be quiet, or you'll bring the orcs and the Alliance down on us, you clumsy oaf. That's right, nod your head, and when we're done speaking, you'll walk away and forget you found me here. Unwelcome presence. Stopping the fellow orcs is going to take more than merely harassing their workers, I'm afraid. I've made a discovery that shed some light on the reason for their presence, and it's reinforced my belief that we must act quickly. Trust no one. Okay, so we may be working together, but that only increases the need for discretion. Once again, be mindful of your words and actions. I can guarantee we're far from the only ones out here. So we have two. We have the Firewing Liaison. Over the past couple of days, I've observed a Blood Elf woman traveling to and from the Fellorc stronghold and conversing with the Fellorc leader. From her body language, she's clearly issuing orders. But why? Whose orders is she conveying? My curiosity got the better of my judgment, and I shadowed her when she left the Fellorc encampment. She headed north to Firewing Point. I stopped before reaching the perimeter of the Blood Elf outpost. Kill her before she leaves the Fellorc camp again. Okay. We have that, and then what happens in Terokkar stays in Terokkar. If word reaches Thralmar that we failed to contain the Fellorcs, we're going to be receiving a lot of company down here. Frankly, I'm not sure I want all that attention, so we're going to keep this little problem under wraps. Got it? If we can inflict enough casualties on the Fellorcs, chances are their presence will never come to the attention of anyone outside Stonebreaker. So let's end it now. Wait in there. Swing your weapon, wave your hands, or whatever it is you do. Just kill Fellorcs. Alright, so we need to kill 10 Bone Chewer Devastators and 6 Bone Chewer Backbreakers. Basically, Devastators are warriors, Backbreakers are warlocks. And then we also have the Firewing Liaison as well, so we'll go ahead and take care of her as well. We'll take care of her in the camp. Strangely enough, though, she's actually in the biggest building in the camp, so we'll take care of her really quick. And we actually, I believe, will get an additional quest in the building, so... let's do that. Oh, look, they even have Horde banners. Well, their version of Horde banners. And there's plenty of backbreakers to go around. Well, hi there. Unfortunately, we are just in a room completely full of enemies. There we go. And one second, this is one of those things that actually irritates me. Okay, I just had to increase my font size again. Fellorc plans. An unseen hand. The writing on the plans is far too delicate and precise to have come from any of the Fellorcs. You can't make out what the text says, but the implications are pretty clear. The Fellorcs are taking orders from the Blood Elves at Firewing Point. Why would the two forces be working together? Rokag might have some insight into this odd alliance. You decide to make your way back to Stonebreaker Hold and show him the map. Okay. Well, before we do that, though, let's take advantage of this building for all we can. And just start killing Backbreakers and Devastators. Well, we're about halfway there on the Backbreakers, so that's good. But we still need a lot of Devastators. There we go, that's 4. That's 5. I hope everybody's having a good Friday. I hope you didn't have TPS for reports to file or whatever. I'm actually recording this before Friday, but, well, given how much work I've actually done today, it might as well be my Friday, because I'm really hoping to have a couple of days off where I can work on some other projects. Because for crying out loud, it's not like I have enough time or anything. Yeah, time is always a factor. There we go. We're officially halfway with the Devastators. Bonk! Bonka bonka bonk. Problem is, I don't need Backbreakers anymore. I need Devastators. And we need four of them. Four! You know what? If I come across a Backbreaker in the meantime, I'm not exactly against that. Okay, so we just need three more Devastators, and then we're done in here. Funniest thing, both of them, at least one of them is a Decepticon name, and one of them sounds like a Decepticon name. Okay, two more. There's one of them.
Fist of Fury!
We need one more Devastator. One more. One more thing. Oh, there you go. That's all 10. So, we'll stop off at the little outpost, but then we're going to head back to Stormbreaker Hold and turn in what we have. Because I think he's going to give us full-on quests for Firewing Point. Hey, look, it's a green Proto-Drake. I don't have that one yet. I don't have a whole lot of mounts. As many of you have pointed out to me, I'm not a mount collector. I'm not a pet collector. I'm not a title collector, a tabard collector, or anything like that. I play the game. I raid. That's pretty much it. I level. I raid. All right. So let's go ahead and turn these in with you. Firewing Liaison. Cade nods at you. Well done. We've brought ourselves a little time. The Blood Elves will grow curious about what happened to their friend. Hopefully by that time, we'll have a better understanding of their intentions. When the time is right, I will inform Rogak of our progress. Okay, and then what happens in Terokkar stays in Terokkar. I know you're well-traveled, but understand, Drakfu, that some stories are best left where they happened. Do we understand each other? Dark lady,
watch your way. Not really. I never understand these things. They're complicated.
Okay, so let's go ahead and head back over to Stonebreaker Hold. Wow, Stonebreaker Hold, huh? Stonebreaker Hold and quick flying music while we do it. Okay, we are back in Stormbreaker Hold. We have a couple of things to do here, including turning in quests, but we got even more money! Showering myself with money. So Rokag.
What is it you have there, Drakfu?
Rokag takes the plans from you and looks them over.
So Cade was right! Those Fellox scum are up to something. I never would have guessed they were colluding with the Blood Elves, though. According to this map, the Fellox are to keep us busy, but why? This is disturbing news, Drakfu. You were correct in bringing it to me right away.
Strength.
Okay, so we don't necessarily know what's going on there, but there is something going on. And we need to investigate, or we need to turn in Investigate Turim, which is actually over with Cenarion Thicket. So again, quick flying music while we do that. Okay, we are back at Cenarion Thicket. Let's go ahead and talk to Earthbinder Tavgarin.
The winds guide you.
What news do you bring, Drakfu? Ethereals? Goods delivered to Turim? Exotic engineering parts? And a Blood Elf getting ready to deliver this last box to Firewing Point? What does this all mean? How does it relate to what happened to the druids in Cenarion Thicket? I think we should have a look inside that box.
I agree. What are these things?
I don't know about you, but I have no idea what all of these things are. I do know one thing, though. They look dangerous. Drakfu, I think you should take this box of parts to Tuki at Stonebreaker Hold to the southeast. He may have some idea of what these are.
Walk with
All right, so back to Stormbreaker Hold, and I'm just going to magic cut for this one. All right, we're back at Stormbreaker Hold. Let's talk to Tuki. Oh, yes, but we also need to turn this in, too. So let's talk to Malakaz really quick.
Blood and thunder.
The spirit, let's see. The spirits await, Drakfu. Have you the pelt of the wolf patriarch?
Yes, I do.
The pelt is even more magnificent than I'd hoped. This is a good omen, Drakfu, and the spirits will favor you for your contribution to this ceremony. I have fashioned a helmet for you from the remaining pelts, Drakfu. It identifies you as a mighty hunter and an ally of the great wolf spirit of Terokkar Forest.
Okay.
I've nearly completed the vestments that I'll wear during the ceremony. As I add the finishing touches, I'd like you to set this incense by the candles near the runestone to my left. I believe it will help us to attract the wolf spirit's attention, since it was made in the days of the Orcish clans. I can almost imagine my ancestors using it at a ceremony, paying tribute to the wolf spirit after a successful hunt. Once you've placed the incense, I'll begin the ceremony.
Go forth to victory.
Okay, let's do that. Turn this off really quick, and all you gotta do is place this incense. And with that, Malakaz dons his wolf vestments.
Wolf spirit of the forest, hear me! Long ago, you were a companion to my people. We gave ourselves to evil, and you were forgotten. But we have returned, spirit. We have returned to honor you again. Favor us with your presence once more.
And there you go, the Terokkar wolf spirit. Under the old wolf design.
But we have returned... let's see.
The Terokkar wolf spirit howls in response to Malakaz's call and expresses its approval.
May our bond with you never be broken again, spirit.
Hopefully.
Loktar.
Reestablishing ties with the wolf spirit is just the beginning of my journey, not the end.
Okay.
This is incredible. I set out on this journey unsure of whether the wolf spirit would answer our summons, and now it feels as though he's always been here. Perhaps he always was, Drakfu. Perhaps he was waiting for the orcs to realize what their choices had wrought.
And with that, I actually get a brand spanking new helmet, which is slightly an improvement, but not really. I might actually not use it. There we go, and let's go ahead and talk to Tuki.
How you doing, man?
Let's see.
You look concerned. What is it, Monk? Oh, no, that's horrible news. I can't believe that all but two of our Sonarian friends are dead. All right, let me have a look at those parts. I'm just hoping they aren't what I suspect that they might be.
All right, report to Stonebreaker Camp.
This calls for immediate action. We have someone out in the fields close to Firewing Point that I want you to speak with. She'll have a better idea of what our next step should be. Report to Sergeant Shawnee out at Stonebreaker Camp and apprise her of the situation. Take the road north out of the hold from the middle of Turum. Follow the road to the east. You'll find the camp on the bank of the river that lies just southwest of Firewing Point. Good luck, Drakfu.
Later.
But we don't know what it is.
Stay away from the view.
All right, fine. Magic cut over to Stonebreaker Camp. Okay, we better get some dang answers.
Bomb parts? So my suspicions were true. That's not something I wanted to be right about.
So bomb parts, that's what it was.
Okay, you and I have some grim business ahead of us then.
Attacking on Firewing Point.
We know that the Blood Elves of Firewing Point are working for Kael'thas and Illidan, and from what you've told me, clearly they are using the Broken of Turim as smuggling go-betweens for the creation of some horrible weapon. Whatever they're up to out there, the most efficient thing that we can do right now is to thin out their numbers. The Firewing Blood Elves need to be taken out. Head over to Firewing Point just to the northeast and see to it.
Alright, so we need to take care of some Blood Elves. Thankfully, Firewing Point is not too far off. So we'll go ahead and take care of them. Whee! See, you can see the buildings right here. And we actually will probably be scaling that tower. Just saying, that might actually happen. And we need to kill 10 defenders, blood warders, and warlocks. So since there is such a tall order... Yeah, I might need to do this, actually. So we'll go ahead and speed things up while I kill off all of the blood elf forces that I need to take on. Be right back. Okay, we're back. We're a little bit out from the Siegebreaker camp, or the Stonebreaker camp, but we got that all taken care of. The speed up is done. And let's go ahead and turn this in with Cade. Oh, no, it's not Cade. It's the other lady. Oh, where is she? There she is. Okay.
Look, Tom.
That's a good start, but based on what you witnessed there in the courtyard, as well as intelligence that I've received, we may have a far more pressing matter at hand.
Alright, the final code.
They're building a second mana bomb in the courtyard. My intel suggests that the final code for the bomb is being held by Sharth Valdun, the overseer of the project at Firewing Point. Drakfu, you have to go back in there and retrieve the final code from him. He keeps himself to the top of the highest spire. Take the final code to the mana bomb that we're working on in the central courtyard and set it off. Only then will it be will we be certain that Stonebreaker Hold is safe.
Mana bomb! So, this brings back a lot of bad memories. A mana bomb, actually, the concept of a mana bomb started here. People might remember in later WoW expansions, mana bombs being used to, I don't know, decimate entire cities, cough, cough, Theramore, cough, cough. That concept was started here. And so at that point, we actually need to take care of it, because as far as they're concerned, these are freaking weapons of mass destruction. So here we go. Now, technically, I could fly all the way to the top, but I actually want to do this the way it was intended, which was on the ground and having to make your way up. So trust me, I'm not taking away too much of it. You go through the main building like you would any other Blood Elf building and walk up the ramp. But here is where it gets interesting, because now we actually have to scale the top part of the building. Oh, and there's actually a quest up here, so that's even better.
See to it that you do, Sharth, or I will personally see you see to your slow torture and death.
Oh, interesting. He's talking to Pathalion the Calculator from Hellfire Peninsula. And he has since stopped talking to him, so let's go ahead and take care of Sharth Valdun.
Wah! You come into my house and threaten me? I thicken not.
Well, yeah, I kind of did. And thank you for the final code, by the way. Appreciate it. Oh, and actually, the quest was not in here. Maybe it's in the building. Yep, it is, because we probably need to escort this prisoner out. Let's take care of that. Since obviously we're going to need quests. Not just for experience, but to get the achievement. Escape from Firewing Point.
Thank goodness for you. Monk, I need you to help me escape. I have information vital to the security of Stonebreaker Hold and probably all of Outland. I came here from the Cenarian Expedition on a diplomatic mission, but as you could see, they weren't very friendly. If you help me get to safety, I can assure you that you will be handsomely rewarded.
Go in peace.
Okay. Let's go ahead and get her out of here.
Okay, let's get out of here.
Yes. Please don't walk. Please don't walk, Isla Starmain. She's walking. My worst nightmares have been realized. It's an escort quest. An old escort quest.
You sure you're ready? Take a moment.
I'm ready. Let's go.
I'm ready. Could you please hurry up, lady?
All right, let's do this.
Yes, please. Let's do this. Don't walk! The reason I didn't do these escort quests back in the day. Really? There was a reason. This is the reason. This is my personal hell.
Can you please hurry up, Night Elf Lady? There's blood elves everywhere. And I don't dare attack them, because then you'll come and help. And then you'll reset. And I don't want you to reset. I just want you to get out of here.
Of course! A freaking flood of water. Okay, keep going, please. Keep going. That's why I don't like the resets. This is like, you have to wait a minute, and then they start walking. Then they give you the convenience of walking. And of course, the other problem is that they are walking aggro magnets. Like that! So now that I have that happen, I might as well take care of the rest. Oh, look, another buddy.
Hi, buddy.
Okay, keep you walking. Keep walking. We're walking and walking and walking. If you aggro the warlock, damn it! I didn't want you to aggro the warlocks. Okay, move, move, move.
Move, 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 move.
Gee, can you tell I'm a little angry by this quest? Do you think you could walk any slower? Just run. This is why I like the escort quests of later expansions. Just get walking again. Just get walking. There's literally a blood elf coming our way. I'm just gonna take care of him now. We are out of the encampment. Can you please just say I will take... Ah, dang it. Keep walking. This just in. Drakkade's escort quests. Old escort quests. Newer ones are fine. Newer ones are interesting. This one, not so much. Are you literally going to make us go all the way to the gate, lady? You are going to make us go all the way to the friggin' gate! You don't get dignified with a fist of fury. You guys do.
Fist of fury!
We're past the gate, lady. You can go ahead and say you'll make it the rest of the way. Okay, I think I can make it on my own from here. Thank you so much for bringing me. Screw you, lady. Get out of here. Give me my credit. All right, let's go ahead and detonate the mana bomb in the middle of the courtyard because this is always satisfying as all crap. I'm gonna aggro the entire camp, but I don't care. Screw you, buddy. All you have to do is input the final code.
Let's get the heck out of here!
They set it off! They set it off!
4, 3, 2, 1, boom!
That's what you get for messing around with a mana bomb. Mana bomb. That's gonna be the title of this part, I think. That's fitting. Mana bomb. Mana bomb! Alright, so let's head over to Stonebreaker Camp. Thankfully, it's not too far off. And then we'll bounce over to Stonebreaker Hold. Okay, who do I turn it into? Oh, do I turn them both in at Stonebreaker Hold? I might just. Okay, quick flying break. All right, welcome back to Stonebreaker Hold, people. Let's talk to Tuki.
You did it! You saved us! You saved Stonebreaker Hold! With their forces decimated, their leader dead, and their mana bomb destroyed, we can all breathe much easier now! Drakfu, I've never seen such selflessness, such heroism! Please accept this on behalf of all of us!
Alright, so we get a downgrade, for the most part, helmet. Whatever. Letting Earthbinder Tavgrin know.
Drakfu, I think that after you've done this celebrating here, you should go back to Sanaria Thicket and speak with Earthbinder Tavgren. I'm certain that he'll want to know what really happened out there.
Spirits.
I agree with you. I think he will want to know. So, the other one is with Rokag. No, actually, Advisor Fela.
A new Valore Delinar.
Escape from Firewing Point. Istha Starmane just left, but she gave me a full rundown on what's going on at Firewing Point. It's understandable that she's quite distraught over what happened to the Sonarian Thicket. She told me how you were instrumental in saving her so that we could get that information. Stonebreaker Hold is indebted to you for your service. Please accept this gift on behalf of us all. And with that, I can get a Terokkar Axe, which is kind of an improvement. I would actually dare say it's not, but better than nothing.
Remember the sun well.
There we go. So with that, I'm also going to do another quick flying break so that we can go to Sonarian Thicket. Okay, here is Earthbinder Tavgren, so let's let him know the horrible news about the mana bomb.
Greetings, traveler.
A bomb utilizing pure mana that can take out whole towns. But why? Why would the Blood Elves create such a thing and use it on us? The Sonarian Thicket was a place of peace and repose. Whatever the reason, it must be locked inside the head of the Warden Trelos, and I have no idea how to cure him. Perhaps his mind will heal in time. Regardless, I want to thank you for helping me to figure out what happened. I can only hope that this tragedy will never befall anyone else ever again.
Cough, cough, Theramore, cough, cough. Alright, but we do get a chest item that isn't really an upgrade either. So, there you go. Alright, with that being done, the next quest that we need to take on, we got a couple of places that we can go. I'm actually going to say let's go over and meet up with Scout Neftis at Grungulvar Village, which is thankfully not too far. You can actually see it off in the distance, but we need to go from a specific angle. So basically, Alliance players go in from the north to do their quests here. We go in from Horde go in from the south. So we both have scouts here, and you'll see why in a little bit. Let's see, so we're just going over the big building in the hoarding, the former Horde encampment. Now it belongs to, well, there you go, Shadowy Executioner. Don't really know what that means. Maybe the Shadow Council? Who knows? All right, so here's Scout Neftis.
It's about time someone came out here. I sent that report to Stonebreaker Hold over a week ago. Blood Elves and their bureaucracy.
All right, who are they?
I don't know who they are, but I know they're hostile. I'm going to give you a disguise, and I want you to go in there and speak with three of them that I've observed as being chatty. Talk with the initiate, the labor, and the advisor. Just watch out, there are a few hunters in there who will be able to see through your disguise, and they look tough. And whatever you do, don't leave the village. The disguise is kind of flimsy. If you lose your disguise, come back to me and I'll give you another.
Okay. So with that, we actually do need to dismount. And then she'll give me a new disguise.
Stay away from the voodoo.
I'm an orc. That's the way it goes.
Let's see. So we need to find a shadowy initiate, a laborer, and an advisor. And all of those are fairly easy to do, but the biggest problem here is all the freaking hunters that are going to be patrolling the area. So first of all, the initiate is actually over here. So let's talk to him first.
Yes, darn it all. Now I'll have to start over from scratch.
What are you doing here?
Practicing. Soon I'll be good enough to join the other summoners and take my turn inside the Shadow Labyrinth at Arkandun. I hope that I'll get the chance to summon something big. Maybe something as big as Murmur, though I wouldn't lose control of him.
Okay, so that's something to keep in mind. They want to go to Arkandun. And then you go in here and the Shadowy Advisor is here. There she is. She's a little gnome. Or he's a little gnome.
And what exactly is it that I can do for you? Can't you see that I'm very busy here discussing matters of import with our illustrious leader? Be quick about your business or I'll have you beaten, Doug.
Advisor, what's the latest news?
Well, I was just giving our leader here a progress report on how everything is proceeding according to plan. It should only be a few more weeks and we'll have this place back in shape. We may want the Shadow Council to only staff the village with orcs, however. That way we can make an ancestral claim and work undercover. Wait a minute. Do I know you? What's your name?
You don't know me. I'm okay. I'll go get some coffee.
And here is a shadowy laborer. We'll talk to her. Oh, crap. Hunter. Oh. Hate these shadowy hunters. I really do. Because you can't really do anything about... Oh, okay, cool. There's a person taking care of her. So, shadowy laborer.
Yeah, what you'd want? Can't you see I'm busy here? The Shadow Council isn't paying me by the hour.
Why are you fixing all this up?
What's it look like I'm doing? I'm fixing the place up all on my own and my dad, so that we can move in. With the base of operations out here in the forest, it'll be easier to keep track of what Shatrath, Alarion, Stonebreaker, and the Cenarian Druids are all up to. Our base in Akandun is just too convenient for that.
Oh, crap. I wanted to read all of that. There we go. It's just too inconvenient for that. Wait a minute, do I know you?
I know. I promise you don't. Please ignore the fact that I went out of disguise. I totally didn't do that. I'm covering my eyes. You can't see me.
There we go. Scout Nectis.
How you doing, man?
Let's see. Who are they?
Good, you finally made it back. Okay, what did you figure out? Who are they?
So, kill the Shadow Council.
What? Those guys are Shadow Council? Drakfu, you have to go back in there and waste them. I want you to take out their leaders, as many of their executioners and summoners as you can. After you're done with that, report back to Advisor Fela at Stonebreaker Hold. Good luck, Monk.
Alright, so, now we
get to kill things. This is gonna be fun.
And with that, we need to take care of Shadowmaster Grieve, the leader, and we'll take care of him first, because he's easy.
Hi, Shadowmaster! Remember me? I got coffee. You didn't tip me well.
There we go. So I'm going to go ahead and speed things up while we take care of the executioners and summoners. Alright, welcome back to Stonebreaker Hold. All we have to do is talk to Advisor Fela after we've killed all of the Shadow Council.
The Eternal Sun guides us.
That is unfortunate news, but of course I made the right choice in sending you out there to help Nephthys. The last thing that we need is the Shadow Council establishing a strong point right on our doorstep. Drakfu, you've earned yourself something nice. Go ahead, take your pick.
And with that, it's still not worth it to me.
Salama,
but thanks. Appreciate it. Kinda not really. Alright, and actually, given the time that we have right now, this is probably a good place to call it for now. When we get back, we will continue our questing in Terokkar Forest, and actually we're going to be stepping into a very familiar place, at least for Draenor fans and for veterans, but also a very sad and somber place for lore fans. So, in the meantime, we will see you guys next time for the next part in the tale of Drakfu.